Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today let me show you how to collaborate using a shared iCloud Drive folder. MacMost is supported by more than 600 viewers just like you. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So Apple came out with new versions of Pages, Numbers, and Keynote for Mac on April 1st. Just before that, they came out with macOS Catalina version 10.15.4. That new version of macOS allowed us to have shared iCloud Drive folders, so you can share an entire folder with somebody else and they could see all of the files in there. Well, if you use that in conjunction with the new Pages, Numbers, and Keynote, you could instantly collaborate on documents using those apps. Before, you had to turn collaboration on for a specific file. But now you can collaborate using any Pages, Numbers, and Keynote file that goes into those shared folders with whomever they are shared with. So it's kind of instant collaboration. You can have a whole folder filled with files and go back and forth on various different documents without having to share each one individually. So the first thing you need to do is create a shared folder. On the top here, I've got a desktop Mac logged into the first demo account. On the bottom, I have a laptop Mac and that is logged into a second demo account. So on the first demo account, I'm going to go and create a shared folder here. Now I am inside of a folder called Projects. That's in my Documents folder, which is part of iCloud Drive. You have to create this folder in iCloud Drive in order to share it. I'm going to just go and create a new folder and I'm going to call this folder Project X and I'm going to make it a shared folder. So with that selected, I can click on the share button here. I can select add people. And then you're going to see the share options here. I'm going to make sure I have it set to only people I invite and anybody can make changes that I invite. I select the method for sending the link. So basically I can copy the link and send it any way I want, but I'm going to use messages just to send it really quickly and easily. I'll hit share. Now I can specify who to send the message to. So I'll send it to this demo account. I can customize the message if I want or just send the default. Now on the second demo account, you're going to see a little notification comes up there. I'll click on that and I'll get a link here. I can click on that link and it's going to ask if I want to open this folder. And yes, I do. I'll hit open and it's going to open it up in a new Finder window and you can see it there. Let's close that Finder window and I could also see that it shows up right at the top level of iCloud Drive. There's Project X. So the reason we're doing this is to collaborate with a variety of files. Previously you could have been working on one file, say in Pages, and then decided to collaborate with somebody using that one file. If you wanted to do it for several files, you would have to do each one individually. But now with shared iCloud folders, we don't have to do that. I've shared this Project X folder with someone else and any Pages, Numbers, or Keynote documents I put in there will instantly be shared collaborative documents with that person. So let's create one. I'm going to go to Pages and create a new document and I'm going to save that in that special folder. So I'm going to go to iCloud Drive and then Documents and then Projects and there's that Project X folder. So I'm going to save it there and I'll call it First. And now that document saved. Now if I look on the other computer, I'll see it appear there in that folder. Now I can also look here on the original computer and I can see here that I've got a file there in Project X. So we both see the same things in that Project X folder. I'm going to double click on that now here on the second demo account and it's going to open it up in Pages. So now we both have that same document opened up in Pages and we can work on it at the same time. So the second account can type another line. And now notice in the second account it says here collaborate and it's green and if you click on it you can see it's shared by somebody inside of a shared folder. Now on the other computer you can see it takes a few seconds there and then it updates and now it also shows green up here and I could see both accounts there sharing it. So now anything one types the other will see. And you can see it appear here on the second computer. So we're collaborating live. We don't have to collaborate live. I could close it here on the first computer and continue to work on it here on the second. And then when I open it back up on the first, I'll see the changes there. So you can work in real time or you could just take turns working on the document. It doesn't really matter. It works all the same. Now, if I wanted to, I can create a second document. And let's say, let's have the second account create that. So create a new pages document. We'll just call this one second. And we'll save it in that same Project X folder. And now we'll look here on the first account and we'll see it added there. You can see there it got added. And we can go in and take a look there at that document. So you can see how you can have multiple documents. You're both working in this collaborative space where you can create various different documents. And you could do the same thing with Numbers or Keynote. So let's launch Numbers here on the first account. Create a new document. We'll save it. And we'll place it in that Project X folder. And then here we'll see that document appear here on the second computer. And I can double click on that one to open it. And you can see you update one, it updates the other. Now if I wanted to stop sharing this folder, I could do it by going to the folder. I'm going to try that on the second account. I'm going to select it and I'm going to hit the share button, show people. And you could see there's me and then there's the original account. It gets confusing because I'm using the same name. I can click on the three dots there and you could see I can remove me from this. So I could stop sharing from this end, or the original owner of this can select that, go into shared, show people, and can go and choose that second account, which has a different name here because it's taken from the contacts list. So I'll click there and you could see I can remove access to this person. So on either end you can kind of cut things off. Just remember that, of course, there is an owner for this folder, which in this case is this first account here. It's the one that created it. And that one's the one that could basically cut other people off but gets to keep the files that are in there. So this is really useful for teams working on a project, but it's also really useful if you have somebody you regularly collaborate with. You can just create this shared folder. You both have access to it. You can both work on any files you want inside of that folder. And you could just always use that folder for whenever you want to collaborate without having to worry about setting it up each time for each document. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.